After the American Revolution, the newly independent Americans had many difficulties. They had trouble settling in the American West. They experienced difficulties with trade. They experienced difficulties with the Spanish. The new government of the United States was not functioning properly. Daniel Shea led a rebellion to protest low farm prices and high state taxes in 1786. The rebellion was Shea's Rebellion, and it lasted for several months. Delegates met in Annapolis, Maryland in 1786 to work out some of the problems. The convention was a failure because so few delegates from other states even attended. Delegates met at the Constitutional Convention in Philadelphia in This plan was known as the Three-Fifths Compromise. They also agreed that Congress could not affect the slave market until, interesting enough, 1808. They passed the Northwest Ordinance in 1787. The law stated that the area east of the Mississippi River and north of the Ohio River would become 3 to 5 states as soon as the population became large enough. The Constitution created the new government of the United States. The federal government consisted of 3 branches of government. The executive branch enforced the laws. The legislative branch created the laws. And the judicial branch would interpret the laws and the Constitution itself. Delegates signed the Constitution on September 17, 1787. Those who supported the Constitution were called Federalists. Anti-Federalists were those who felt that the Constitution gave the central government way too much power. Delegates then met at the Constitutional Convention in Philadelphia in 1787. They met to create a plan for a stronger central government. 2 plans were discussed. The Virginia Plan favored a strong central government. The Virginia Plan gave more power to the larger states. The New Jersey Plan favored equal power between the states. The delegates agreed on a compromise. The delegates decided that 3 out of 5 slaves would be included in the population and the taxation count of the Constitution was going to be the law of the land in America. And it began in 1788. George Washington was elected to lead the country as the very first president of the United States in 1789. Congress added a Bill of Rights to the Constitution in 1791. These were the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. They protect individual rights. Though the country was off to a rocky start, the United States of America, in its primitive state, will become one of the most powerful countries that this world has ever seen.